There are people who think that Tramadol is not an opioid. Tramadol is an opioid. It is different from other opioids due to its unusual characteristics. Some of these characteristics offer an advantage for Tramadol over other opioids. On the other hand, these unusual characteristics make Tramadol more dangerous than the other opioids. Tramadol is the generic drug name, and there are various brands in Canada: Tramacet, Zytram, Ralivia, Ultram, and Tridural. Today, I will answer 10 common questions that people ask me about Tramadol. So, let's talk about Tramadol today. Question number one, how does Tramadol work? Well, before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to replace medical advice. It is for educational purposes only. If you need medical advice, contact your doctor. In case of emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call 911. Tramadol is a synthetic opioid. This means it's done in laboratory as opposed to naturally occurring opioids such as codeine and morphine, which are found in the opium poppy. When a person takes a Tramadol pill or tablet, a suppository, or even by injection, Tramadol will need to be converted in the liver to a more potent substance called O-dismethyltramadol or M1. Some people do not have the ability to transform Tramadol into M1 and will not produce the more potent form of Tramadol. Approximately 5% of Caucasian people do not have the enzyme to transform Tramadol to M1, so they will not respond to Tramadol even if they are prescribed higher doses. They will only get the adverse effects. But Tramadol will have an additional effect in the pain system, which is very helpful for people who have chronic pain. Tramadol will block the reuptake or reabsorption of serotonin and noradrenaline, two substances that are needed in the central nervous system in people who have chronic pain. In chronic pain, we use antidepressants called SNRIs or serotonin noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors with the intention to increase serotonin and noradrenaline in the central nervous system. So Tramadol is like taking three pills for one, or three in one. However, it's hard to treat depression with Tramadol because the effects will be unpredictable, so it is safer to prescribe one medication for pain and one for depression instead of combining them in one tablet. What seems to be a big advantage, especially for people with chronic pain and depression, is what makes Tramadol so unpredictable and dangerous. People with chronic pain who take Tramadol usually take other medications that also increase serotonin in their brain, like antidepressants, anti-migraine, other opioid medications, anti-nausea, and even some herbal supplements. When too much serotonin accumulates in the brain, there is the risk of serotonin syndrome. One of the first symptoms is mental confusion, and if serotonin syndrome, if this condition is not recognized quickly, it may progress to severe serotonin syndrome, which leads to seizures and death. Question 2. Is Tramadol a good painkiller? Tramadol and M1 will activate opioid receptors in the brain, spinal cord, and in the peripheral nerves, and will stop the pain. This is called analgesia. Tramadol is similar in potency compared to codeine, and for this reason, it's commonly referred as a weak opioid. However, the concept of weak and strong opioid is relative. What this really means is that you need a higher dose of Tramadol to get the same effects of a low-dose morphine, which is considered higher potency. So people usually say that Tramadol is weak and morphine strong. Well, in this case, fentanyl is super strong because you would need micrograms of fentanyl to have the same effects of hundreds of milligrams of Tramadol. There are various systematic reviews or randomized trials of Tramadol for chronic pain. I will summarize some of them here. A Cochrane review published in 2019 showed moderate quality evidence that Tramadol alone or in combination with acetaminophen probably has no important benefit on pain intensity and physical function over placebo in people with osteoarthritis. A Cochrane review published in 2017 showed low or very low quality evidence that Tramadol could have some benefit for neuropathic pain. A Cochrane review published in 2013 showed very low quality evidence that Tramadol makes little difference for low back pain compared to NSAID celecoxib. A systematic review published in 2020 showed low quality evidence that Tramadol as a single agent was not better than placebo for patients with fibromyalgia. Question number three. What is the proper dose of Tramadol? How do I know if I need higher doses? Well, we usually start Tramadol with the lowest possible dose. Tramadol can be found as a short-acting or long-acting medication. The short-acting usually starts in 30 minutes, the effects, and they last about 4 hours. The long-acting Tramadol takes longer to start the effects, but it lasts about 8 to 12 hours. In some parts of the world, there is an extended-release Tramadol that is taken only once a day, as the effects last 24 hours. And there are also some pills that contain a mix of short-acting and long-acting Tramadol. I recommend that you ask your doctor or your pharmacist and find out what type of Tramadol preparation you are receiving, as there are many different options in the market. Because of the risks of serotonin syndrome that I explained before, Tramadol has a maximum dose allowed. It depends on the brand of the Tramadol, but for short-acting Tramadol pills, if the pills contain 37.5 milligrams of Tramadol, then we recommend taking no more than 10 pills a day. If the short-acting Tramadol pill contains 50 milligrams, then we recommend no more than 8 pills per day. And for the long-acting Tramadol, they come in pills of 50, 100, 150, 200, or 225, depending on the brand. The maximum dose of any Tramadol is 400 milligrams a day. This maximum dose is mainly because of the risk of serotonin syndrome that can lead to death. Question 4. Can I take Tramadol with other painkillers like acetaminophen or gabapentin? Well, some Tramadol pills come already mixed with acetaminophen. For example, Tramacet, the pill contains Tramadol plus acetaminophen. So you need to be careful if you take additional doses of acetaminophen because the maximum that your liver can tolerate is around 4,000 milligrams of acetaminophen per day. Acetaminophen is the type of drug that is hidden in a lot of other medications like cold, cough, headaches medications. It's very important that you don't take more than 4,000 milligrams of acetaminophen per day to preserve your liver function. People who take gabapentin can also take Tramadol, but you need to be very careful because the two medications can cause sedation, sleepiness, and poor concentration. And combining the two will only accentuate these side effects. Question 5. Is Tramadol a risky pain medication? The short answer is yes. Tramadol can cause death because it is an opioid, and opioids can cause the person to stop breathing while they are sleeping. This is even more common when Tramadol is taken with other sedating drugs like gabapentin, baclofen, sleeping pills like benzodiazepines, antidepressants, antipsychotics, alcohol, or even when the person is taking with other opioids. Naloxone is an antidote to revert an opioid overdose. However, overdose by Tramadol is not completely reverted by administration of naloxone. The other risk of Tramadol that we already mentioned in this video before is serotonin syndrome. And this is common in people who take on the medications that also increase serotonin in the brain. If you want to read the script of this video, there is a link in the description of this video below that you can check and read the script. Question number 6. Is Tramadol safe during pregnancy and breastfeeding? Tramadol crosses the placenta. We do not have any evidence that it causes any malformation to the fetus. However, prolonged use during pregnancy can result in withdrawal symptoms in the neonate. And we know that neonatal opioid withdrawal or abstinence syndrome can be life-threatening. So we recommend that pregnant women discontinue opioid as soon as they know that they are pregnant, but tapering the opioid, lowering the dose, should be done very slowly and under medical supervision to avoid uterine contractions and premature labor and miscarriage. For breastfeeding women, Tramadol is found in the breast milk. And in some cases, the doses in the breast milk are quite high and could cause serious overdose to the baby, leading to brain damage due to lack of oxygen or even death. Question 7. Will Tramadol help my sleep or keep me awake? Well, opioids are known as narcotics because they produce a state of stupor, paralysis, sleepiness, and relaxation. Morphine, which has been used for thousands of years, is an opioid that was named after Morpheus, the Greek god of dreams. However, Tramadol has those unusual characteristics that I mentioned before, increasing serotonin and noradrenaline, and in some people, this will make them to disrupt the sleep, causing insomnia and poor sleep quality. Question 8. Can I drive if I use Tramadol? Well, when the person is starting treatment with Tramadol, it is better to avoid driving or operating any heavy machinery until the dose is stable and no more adjustments are being made on the dose. Once the person is on a stable daily dose, the doctor can reassess if the person is too drowsy, sleepy, or too dizzy. Drowsiness and dizziness are the two most common adverse effects of Tramadol. But most people will adapt to Tramadol and these adverse effects will diminish over time. Then, when the person is not feeling sleepy or drowsy anymore, they can resume driving. Question number 9. Do I need to stop using alcohol if I'm prescribed Tramadol? Both alcohol and Tramadol inhibit the brain function and cause the same side effects of sleepiness, dizziness, and can also make the person stop breathing, which may lead to overdose and death. Question 10. Can people abuse Tramadol? Yes. Tramadol is a drug that can be abused. It is an opioid, and some people will have euphoria similar to other opioids like oxycodone or fentanyl. A person who uses Tramadol regularly will have withdrawal symptoms if they stop taking it abruptly. These withdrawal symptoms are very unpleasant. Well, we know that tolerance to Tramadol develops very quickly. Even when the pain condition has resolved, the individual will continue using Tramadol just to avoid the withdrawal symptoms. A small proportion of people will develop an opioid use disorder, which is basically losing control of how much Tramadol they are taking. This is a serious mental health disease and it has to be treated as soon as possible. Opioid use disorder, or OUD, occurs in about 5% of people who use opioids every day. So if you like this video, press the thumbs up button here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button. Watch my next video here. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Goodbye.